Shoestring returns next Sunday evening at 9:05. The theme to the series is available on a BBC single, and a new novel by Paul Abelman, Shoestring's Finest Hour, is available from booksellers, price £1.
Tomorrow on BBC Two, Rock Week continues with a late-night concert of what's best in rock. On Wednesday, Cream, highlights from the farewell concert by one of the most influential bands of the 60s. On Thursday, a celebration of heavy metal music with Rainbow at Castle Donington. And on Friday, Randy Newman, the sardonic American singer-songwriter.
Oh, I'll step out in style with my sincere smile and my dancing bare outrageous, alarming, courageous, charming.
Some of the highlights from a week of films, concerts and documentaries. Rock Week starting tomorrow on BBC Two.
In 10 minutes here on BBC One, Everyman reports from Northern Ireland on the price of peace. Now the news with Jan Leeming.
The West German Chancellor, Helmut Schmidt, seems certain of a bigger parliamentary majority after today's general election. Within an hour of the polls closing tonight, the computers had sampled the early results and produced a prediction with such confidence that the Christian Democrats, who campaigned under Franz Josef Strauss, have already conceded defeat. They will remain the largest single party. Chancellor Schmidt's Social Democrats will be second, but a strong showing by his coalition partners, the Free Democrats, should keep the coalition in office. This report from Mike Mackay in Bonn.
More than anything, these results tonight are being seen as a vote against Franz Josef Strauss. The veteran Conservative has seen his Christian Democratic Party drop nearly 3% of the vote, and there's little doubt that much of the blame will be heaped on him in the cold light of tomorrow. Though it means Helmut Schmidt stays as Chancellor, the West German leader can't be entirely happy with his party's own performance. While voting today, he was hoping to see the Social Democrats return as the largest party. Instead, he must once more begin the process of forming a coalition government with the Liberal Free Democrats, led by Hans-Dietrich Genscher, the foreign minister in the last coalition. When Franz Josef Strauss came out to vote today, he knew this was the last chance in a long career for him to win.